Hey everybody, you know, we project a lot of the machines we test here simply as a way for me to put more miles on the ATVs and UTVs, but also as a way for me to test a lot of different products and get a feel for what's out there for products so that I can kind of guide you as to what I find along the way. And I've been really fortunate to run across the Quadra gear bags. Now, we had tested them in the past in a short little test and then moved on, and I didn't get to spend enough time with them. This time along, I was fortunate enough to actually get to meet the owner of Quadra gear bags and talk to him and learn his story on how these bags came about, because it seems like Jared actually has done, you know, some really serious backpacks, military type, submersible backpacks for the military. Still does crossfiregear.com. You can check out that site for a lot of holsters. Really high grade stuff. And it seems like because of that, one of his real joys in life was ATVing and UTVing. And he actually used another brand bag that he bought and took out there and went riding. And in the rain and the muck, he found out that when he opened it up, all his gear was wet. And he goes, well, you know, what am I doing? I'm going to just, you know, I guess I'll just make me my own bag. After all, you know, he is a designer too. So he made his own bags, set them to his specifications that he wanted, you know, high quality design to look good and to hold up well. And what he did is after he built a set, you know, first time his friends saw it, they go, well, you know, could you make me a set of these bags? And then another friend, well, would you mind making me a set of these bags? And the next thing you know, he says, I'm in the bag business, I guess. So now he's been making the Quadra gear bags. And you can just see from looking at it, it's not your ordinary bag. It's much heavier. It's got a more serious construction to it, so that it's got a thicker paneling around the outside and the bottom so that it holds up, holds its shape. It's got 9 places to fasten it to your rack or the bed of your vehicle, and they come with, find it here, I'm getting ahead of myself, but it comes with a whole bag of different types of tie downs that you can put together to make this fastened just right to your machine. So it isn't just come with a standard tie that you're going to tie in 4 places or maybe 6. It's got 9 different areas you can tie it down and an assortment of straps that you can use to tie it to your machine. Again, you notice the design. The design has a shape to it that makes it look better when it's on the machine instead of just a big square bag, so it's easier to look over the top of or look behind it. But one of the side benefits of this bag is, oddly enough, even at the slower speeds, that the air kind of goes over it and you don't get this dusty side to the bag. Especially if this, you know, for the bag that's on the back, you notice that when you go to it, that's one of the reasons I hate bags that open to the rear, is it's all dusty. Well, with this shape, as the air is flowing over it, you know, on the back bag, it helps keep this area a little cleaner to get to. So, again, you know, heavily constructed, built with a water-resistant material, and if for some reason you get in a real serious downpour, there is, and I guess I won't get to it this easy to show you, there's a zippered compartment in the back right here that has a hidden and attached rain fly. So if you're going to leave it set overnight in the rain, or you're going to be riding all day in heavy rain, you can put a rain fly over, and suddenly you have more than just a water resistant bag. It's now waterproof. It'll hold its shape. On top of it, you'll see that it's got heavier than typical cords to, if you're going to lash, say, your rain jacket or something that you want right here handy to it. 4 buckles to hold the lid on, and you'll notice around the outside, 2 straps for lifting it on and off if you're going to carry it in with you if you're someplace, and it's got the mole system. And these are really heavy ties on here that you can attach other bags or other gear to, and you don't have to worry about those things pulling out. Again, I have to say that the whole bag, every place you look, this thing is built with quality in mind. And that's something that's getting harder and harder to find nowadays, because you're finding more and more people are competing to be the cheapest product that's out there. And you have less and less people competing to be the best product. That reminds me of a sign I saw years ago on a parts store or a service department or something. You know, how do you want it? You want it good or do you want it cheap? Because you can't have both. And that kind of applies here, because this is a quality bag. It's not inexpensive, but it's quality. Okay, so off of that little soapbox, you open this thing up and you still have another flap in here that's protecting the zippers. If you look at the zippers, they're heavier than standard zippers, and they're put in, I guess we could say, upside down, so that actually there's a cloth part covering. So once again, it's covered here, so dust and dirt and water is not going to get in it. You open the flap up, and now you've got heavier zippers that are sealed, and you see that inside here you've got map pockets or open pockets that you keep something you want to get to easy. If you open the bag up, again, you're going to see that inside the bag, the entire inside is bright yellow. And part of the reason for that is just to make your gear in dark or cloudy conditions just a lot easier to find your gear that you're looking for. It's got three movable dividers inside the bag that you can move around to size like you want it to be. A net going around the entire inside to store smaller items. Everything's heavy. It's not just a piece of material here. It's got padding inside it for protection. And even the little Velcro there, Velcro on the side spots, seals it really good. Rubberized for protection, because if you're out on the trail, you're always going to be banging into branches and sticks and stuff. And they make an assortment of sizes. Three basic sizes of these bags. They make a smaller one, and I don't remember what size it is. You're going to have to look on the website. This is the Skyline. The bigger one is the Bazooka. And as I said, they've got the mole system that goes onto this bag around here that you can attach other bags to, but they also make an assortment of bags. The Stinger that you can use as a fender bag, or we'll talk more about the uses to that one. More like a handlebar bag you can put on your handlebars or your T-grip. And then a small bag that you can fasten to the mole system, or just fasten to someplace if you want to just have your binoculars, something like that, handy. They make a tool rack, which, I can't wait to put my tools in here, because this is one of those things, if you carry a bunch of tools, and I do, I wrap them in, whatever I have, towels, or put them in, and they're just rattled around. So this way, you can put a bunch of your tools in, you've got them all here handy. When you're done, this thing rolls up, this goes around it to fasten it, and you can put your whole wrapped tools right in one of these compartments or one of these other bags. If you want more information on the full line of the Quadra Gear bags, go to their website, check them out. Just amazing. We're going to put them on our project Suzuki King Quad here and be using these things. With winter coming up, I'll get to test that waterproofness, I suppose. And then what I have here, the bigger one that we have on the back, is the Bazooka. You can see the size of this one's larger, perfect for the back, but it's also can be used in the back of your UTV. Now here's the other news on that. While the Bazooka can fit in the back of the Razor or UTV like that, as we're projecting this, one of the wonderful things of getting to meet Jared and talk to him is to find out ahead of time that he's in the development stages of making the Bazooka bag, maybe like 6 inches deeper, specifically for use on a UTV. So you've even got more room to carry stuff. So, that's kind of most of the line of the Quadra Gear bags. Real quality, bags. I think this is the type of bag that you're gonna buy and use for as long as you've got your ATV, and probably longer, because it's gonna last. It's one of those things. What did my Canoga mixer say when I was in construction? The quality remains long after the price is forgotten. And, you know, I think that's what you're going to find with these, this quality. You're going to pay more than you will for, you know, one of the cheaper bags that you're going to look at. But you're going to buy this bag, and you're going to find all the different features, like the quality zippers, the rainproof, rain fly, the rubberized protection, the heavier duty or tie downs, the system for lashing it. Every piece of this is made because the guy that has designed it and manufactured it uses his own products all the time. So that's it. You know, you'll see more of these as we show our projecting of the Suzuki and put more miles on it with these bags, soon to be filled with gear. So hey, until next time, see you on the trail. God bless.